Assalamu alaikum, namaste, and welcome everybody to the news hour with your favorite host in those Jennifer Rogers. And if you are new to our channel, let me tell you what you're supposed to do. You are supposed to share this video with all your friends and family so they are aware about all the things happening in Qatar and all around the world. And with that, we are also available on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, where we post a lot of interesting content and it's just for you. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel as well, where we post a lot of interesting content. And do not forget to visit our other channel, which is qatarday.com. And with this, I have about 3 local updates and 1 international. So let's just get into it. The first one, which is MOI, now cautious people about those suspicious calls about bank cards that people are getting nowadays. They're asking people to be very cautious about that. Ministry of Interior has once again urged people to be cautious about dealing with suspicious messages sent by cyber criminals about blocking one's bank card. So they have said you have to be vigilant and take the right steps to avoid facing victims to them. Remember to contact the Economic and Cybercrime Combat Department, the MOI said in a tweet earlier. Now the ministry listed the steps to be taken if an individual receives a message saying his or her card has been blocked. Now these are the things that you need to keep in mind. First, you need to contact the bank immediately. Second, ignore the message once confirmed it's fake. Just ignore it. Third, contact the Economic and Cybercrime Combating Department on 66815757. Now the ministry has also recently advised people to protect their online IDs to bank accounts, social media profiles, and the ID, the email ID that you guys are using strong passwords and by changing them periodically. So you need to remember to keep changing them, okay? And never share your password, OTPs, and bank informations with others, be it whoever it is. Do not share it with anybody you know, or even if you don't know. And earlier it has advised people not to respond to to the messages through which fraudsters try to blackmail victims. Now your awareness and attention to the emerging forms of crime enhances your security and safety, the MOI has added in the tweet. Last month, the ministry has announced that cyber crime gang that defrauded its victims for nearly Qatari riyals 10 million were busted in an operation named Uncovering the Mask. Now, the Economic and Cyber Crime Combating Department arrested members of the criminal gang for being involved in cyber crime, fraud operations, and stealing funds from the customers of the bank. So you have to be really, 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 really cautious about who you are sharing your bank details with, who you are. If you're getting calls about all this, please verify that it's not a fraud call. And once you know it is a fraud call, please, please, please just ignore it. Now, after that, let's just talk about how all school children in Qatar now have to undergo COVID-19 saliva test. I'm sorry. So the new COVID-19 saliva based testing method is very easy and highly accurate, as said by Dr. Al-Kuwari, chairperson of the Department of Laboratory Medicine and Pathology at Hamad Medical Corporation, encouraging parents to let their children undergo COVID-19 tests if needed to ensure that they are free of infection. She said that the new method of saliva based test for COVID-19 is convenient for children. The saliva-based test is less, it's less intrusive for children and does not require a swab to be inserted in the nose or the back of the mouth or throat, like any common method of detecting COVID-19. Also, therefore, we encourage all parents, as said by them, they said that we encourage all parents not to hesitate to undergo the PCR testing to ensure that they are free of COVID-19. And the Ministry of Public Health earlier announced that plans to introduce saliva-based COVID-19 tests for children from today, that is Sunday, September 20th, that was yesterday. Anyways, as part of the national testing program to gain a better understanding for infectious rates. Now let me get to the third local update of the day, which is Qatar Airways now announces October flight resumptions. So yes, they are resuming a lot of flights in the month of October, and they have put out a list which I'm going to read out to you guys. Now, Qatar Airways continues to lead the aviation industry, offering more global connectivity than any other airlines. In order not to lose their title, it introduced more flight resumptions. Now, they have resumed flight to Oman. Now, daily flights starting from the 15th of September, carry of passenger limited to 8 a.m. to Doha only. Then they have started for Clark, increasing to 9 weekly flights from the 20th of September. Then Copenhagen is starting, increasing to 10 weekly flights from the 15th of September. Dhaka has been increased to 7 flights from the 19th of September. And Entebbe has been, started 3 weekly flights starting from the 2nd of October. They're going to start. Hanoi from 4 weekly flights starting from the 3rd of October. Madrid increasing to 10 weekly flights from the 1st of October. And Manchester increasing about 17 weekly flights from 15th of October. Manila increasing 17 weekly flights from 2nd of October. Seychelles is 3 weekly flights starting from 15th of October. Stockholm's increasing 10 weekly flights from 15th of October. And these are all the flights that they are going to restart from the month of October. Now with that, let me get to the first international news of the day, which is Chinese. Now China erects 9 buildings on Nepal's land, restricts entry for the Nepalese locals. So China has managed somehow to increase 9 buildings on land owned by Nepal, while disallowing Nepalese authorities from stepping foot in that area. Reports suggest that the Chinese are taking advantage of the border standoff with India and the absence of the Nepalese security forces owing to approach winter season to gradually capture land in the region. Now, the most recent incident has come to light from Nepal's Humal district, where the Chinese have cunningly and very smartly constructed a building in Namhyak village. In fact, work on total of 9 buildings in the same village is now completed. China does not stop there and even restricted the entry of Nepalese locals near the buildings. According to the report, the matter first came to light when the head of the village council, Vishnu Bahadur Lama, visited the border area during a routine tour. He wasn't allowed. That's when this came into the picture, when they came to know that, this thing happened. And he revealed that the Chinese People's Liberation Army has completed the restrictions the constructions of 9 buildings in the Lamcha area of Limi village. So with this, I'm done with all the updates for today. Thank you so much, everybody, for logging on to Qatar Day. Keep loving, keep supporting, keep watching Qatar Day, the pulse of the nation. Me, your host and those, Jennifer Rogers, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Same time, same place. Until then, remember, it's very, very important right now that you take care of yourself, you eat healthy and you stay healthy. Until then, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Khuda hafiz. And thank you, everybody, for commenting. Thank you. Bye-bye.